The motion of objects showing relationship between distance traveled and time taken to cover the distance can be represented in a diagram formed by drawing their distance-time graphs. A distance-time graph shows how the distance traveled by a moving object changes with time. So graphs are generally plotted on a graph paper. Okay, now let's see how the graphical representation of motion can be done on the graph paper. So first you need to draw two lines at right angle to each other on a graph paper. Then mark the horizontal line as OX. It is known as your x-axis. Similarly, mark the vertical line as OY. It is called the y-axis. The point of intersection of OX and OY is known as the origin, O you can say. Further, the quantity which is made to vary at our will is called the independent variable, and the other which varies as a result of this change is called the dependent variable. In this case, time is an independent quantity, so time is shown on the x-axis. Label the x-axis by writing time and its unit, and in the bracket you can write the unit and mark an arrow there, or followed by an arrow you can say. Okay, so in this case, distance is an dependent quantity, so distance is shown along the y-axis. So label the y-axis by writing distance and its unit in bracket, followed by an arrow again. Now you should choose suitable scales so as to represent the large values of time and distance conveniently on the small graph paper. Okay, mark values for the time and distance on the respective axis according to the scale you have chosen. Further, mark the data which has been provided to you, that is the data of distance and time covered like by the object. Then next step is join all the marked points with the help of pencil. Now whatever you have joined, that line will tell you or is the distance time graph for the motion of the car. Okay, we'll see the distance time graph for the uniform motion, non-uniform motion, and the object which is at rest. So now we know that one can represent the motion graphically by plotting a distance time graph. Right, the first thing what you need to do is you need to collect the data to be plotted and arrange it in a tabular form. So already we have a tabular form here, the data arranged in the tabular form you can see. So the distance is in kilometers here and the time is in minutes here. Okay, so the second thing what you're going to do is you're going to draw the x-axis and the y-axis on the graph. Then the parameters to represent them along this axis, that is x-axis, you'll be having the independent variable, that is time, and the distance will be along the y-axis, which is the dependent variable, right? Then the next step is you need to decide the scale. Okay, so here it's like 1 centimeter is equal to 1 minute, and like 1 centimeter on the x-axis you can say, and on the y-axis you have 1 centimeter is equal to 1 kilometer. Okay, now what you have to do next is mark the data which has been given in the tabular form and join all the points, data points, and what you will find is you will get a straight line representing the distance time line graph. Okay, now remember students, when the distance time graph is a straight line, it indicates that the object is moving at a constant speed, which means that the object is in the uniform motion. So remember, whenever the distance time graph line is a straight line, that time the object is moving in the uniform motion. Am I clear? Yes. Now, from this distance time line graph, one can find the distance that has been covered by the body at any point of time. Children, on the other hand, if the distance time graph is a curved line, it means the motion of the body is non-uniform. Okay, now if you see this example here, the data is already been given in the tabular form, and if you're plotting the distance time graph for that date by taking the data, you'll get a curved line. Okay, now this curved line shows that the body is undergoing non-uniform motion. Means what? The body is moving and its speed is changing every time. Okay, so at that point when the body is in non-uniform motion, you will never get a straight line on your distance time graph. You will always get a curve, and this curve indicates that the object is in non-uniform motion. Now here is the distance time graph for a body at rest. Remember students, if a body does not change its position with time, that is if the body is at rest, okay, that the distance time graph will be a straight line parallel to the time axis, that is x axis. Okay, so what you have to remember is when a distance time graph is a straight line parallel to the time axis, that is the x axis, then the body is at rest. Okay, it's not moving, it is stationary. Okay, the position of the line on the x axis will depend upon the distance of the body from the observer, right? Okay, let's draw the conclusion from this distance time graph. So if the distance time graph is a straight line, then the motion of the object is uniform, or you can say that the object is in the uniform motion. If the distance time graph is a curved line, then the motion of the object is non-uniform. So you can say that the object is in non-uniform motion. And if the distance time graph is a straight line, okay, parallel to the x axis, that time the object is at rest. Okay, so with the help of the line curve being drawn on the graph, you can easily make it out the motion of the object, whether it's in uniform motion, whether it's in non-uniform motion, or whether it's in rest. Okay, for the students, if the distance time graph of any body is given, its speed can be calculated using the slope of the graph. Okay.